Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Grand Theft Auto 5 once again for another aircraft showcase. This one is going to be the Honda Jet that was released by Skyline GTR Freak, the 420 HA. And we have got some cool things to go over with this airplane. We've got a little bit of a small little door here in the front and the nose, so you can put some things away there. You've got opening doors. You have opening and closing blinds, actually. You can do that with one of the door commands. There's the interior there. This airplane's kind of known for how unique the wing is on it. It has the pylon that holds the engines on it. You see there? It's not attached to the fuselage, which is pretty interesting. The texture work on the leading edge could be done a little bit better. It's kind of so-and-so. My guy doesn't have a head. Don't mind that. Big winglets on this airplane. And it's just an all-around cool-looking plane. It really is. I think this one's going to be very popular amongst the 5M community because you can get in and out of every airport in San Andreas, including Grapeseed, which is a really nice thing. So without further ado, let's go fly the Honda Jet and I'll show you what it's all about. Walk over here, hop on in. Has some clipping issues of him getting in and out of the plane. You'll notice, especially when you're looking behind you and like that, he puts his hand through the airplane. It's a small jet. Let's go ahead and open up our options. Doors, close them all. And you'll see the little side windows here. They'll open just like that. And we'll go fire the engine up. There it goes. We have working landing and taxi lights. But GTA will have them shut off by the time we get down to the runway. Guarantee it. We're going to do something a little bit different today. We're going to take off on the cross runway and then do a loop. Fly over, not an actual like loop-de-loop. We're gonna just kind of loop around, fly over the airfield, and then make a right base for Grapeseed. That's what we're gonna do. We have working ailerons, yes we do, and elevator. And rudder, of course. Yeah, we'll use the cross runway and take off towards Sandy Shores. That way we can see how tight the airplane will turn. It's got a pretty decent turn radius on it. As long as you stay ahead of it, it's good to go. Which is a really nice thing. Not sure how many people it holds. It does hold quite a few. How many seats do we have? We can see it. Here's the interior. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4. It looks like it's going to hold. And then a co-pilot, of course. It does have emissives inside on the attitude indicator. That's one thing that I wish it didn't have. If you run any kind of visuals like Visual 5 or something like I'm running here, it'll blow those things out like crazy. Especially at night, it's really hard to see. So yeah, we're going to come over here like this, and we're going to just crank it left. So we don't hit the bush with our wing. Flip around this way. And we'll line up. Doesn't take much runway to take off. It does take quite a bit of runway to stop it, though. Keep that in mind. All right, let's go flying. Let's go add... Well, actually, let's make sure we have our lights on. There we go. And add full power. A little bit of right rudder there. This is about a good speed for rotation. On back we go. And it's up. Gear up. And we're out of Sandy Shores. Right over Mount Gordo area, we're gonna keep turning right and we're gonna level off about right here, just between the second and third line on our attitude indicator over there. Fly over the prison. Looks like we're gonna have a nice little sunset on our landing in Grapeseed. So now we're on a right downwind for the runway over there on the right. Give us plenty of room. It is a jet, so it does take a little bit longer to get it slowed down than with a, say, a Cuban 800 or something. We're going to fly over the end of the runway over here, start our descent. And what I start doing is that, like, you'll see the speed brakes are modeled, and that'll shut the engines off and stuff. But you have to kind of feather the throttle back and forth here to get it slowed down. Gear down. Otherwise, it's going to be a little bit too fast for you. Landing lights are on. Yes, they are. We're lining up on the runway now. Keep doing that pulsing of the left trigger here. We've got the runway in sight. Still pulsing the left trigger, so we don't get too fast here. And what we'll do is we'll end up cutting the engines completely before we get to the runway and floating it in. You can do that. It won't sink like crazy here. So here we are coming down like this, and we're gonna kill the engines right there and let it flare. We're down. Full stop, full stop, full stop. Man, you see how much runway that takes? Holy crap. Yeah, you gotta cut it a little bit earlier than that. Now, I've been able to get it in and out of this airport a few times. We'll practice that again. Actually, you know what? We'll just wait for the next day, so the sun will be up, so it's not gonna be nighttime. How about that? The next day is upon us. Let's go flying, folks. That way we don't have to worry about nighttime approaching us. Fire it up. You know what to do, man. There he goes. Lights are on. Taxi to the right. And I'll show you just how fast you can get out of Grapeseed. Full power. Start pulling back on that right there. And we are airborne. Gear up. And we can really clear all of it out just like this. Now, keep an eye on our speed there. We start losing speed about this angle of attack right there. So bring that nose down a little bit. We'll start gaining airspeed. So it can still climb out pretty quick. It really can. All right, so let's say the winds are sloop. We're going to use that cross runway again like we did last time. So we'll end up flying over Harmony actually this time. That'll be pretty cool. Use those spoilers there a little bit. And the flaps come down with the speed brakes as well when you get the left trigger enough down, which is pretty cool how it does that. All right, back inside view here, and we are going to do a left downwind for the runway. Right around these mountains. A nice left downwind here. Still have to hold that left trigger back a little bit. As you saw, our landing in Grapeseed wasn't the greatest because this thing is so fast. It really is quick. All right, looking good here. Let's keep this altitude and keep turning. Gear down. Land light on. Looking all right here. A little bit more left. Still pulsing that left trigger, left and right here. And we got the runway. Watch out for the tower. I'm going to cut it a little bit earlier this time because it does take a lot to get this thing slowed down. Short final now, and we'll kill the engines right here. Bring that nose up, let it flare. There we go. That was a little bit better. Still, it has a pretty long roll on it, but you can, if you just stay ahead of it, you'll be fine. Let's go ahead and make a left turn here. We'll take the crosswind and we'll go try landing at Grapeseed one more time and try to get a decent landing over there. Full power. On up we go. Gear up. Turn to the right here. And release the power. We don't need that much power. Still bringing the nose up. Gear down. This will be a quick arrival into the airport of Grapeseed. Alright. Now I'm starting to keep clicking that left trigger back and forth. Just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 like that. Maintaining this airspeed here. Because it's going to be fast. This is a good altitude right here. Yeah, we're a little bit low on the glide slope where we should be. Let's try this right here. This is a little bit better now. But this time I'm going to end up killing the engines over the trees and rocks right there, the ravine. Last time we just went a little too far forward of that and we paid for it. Let's see how this works this time over the ravine. So kill the engines right here. There they go. Bring that nose up. And we're down. Gotta love the screech on dirt, right? Yeah, So you can get it stopped here pretty decently. You just got to keep on practicing. Let's do another turnaround. Let's go fly to Los Santos International Airport, shall we? There we go. Back this way. And we'll land on the cross runway from the ocean side. We never do that. Just changing things up, you know? Let's see how much we can get away with. We're halfway down the runway. Well, quarter way down the runway. And we're going to go full power here. Here we go. Full power. Bring that elevator back. And we are in the air. Just like that. Gear up. Blasting out of grape seed here. As you can see, we have some good speed here for GTA. We've got 155 miles per hour, as you can see on the top right. So it'll get you where you need to go pretty quick, actually. We're going to fly the Zancudo River Valley here. And we'll be set up for a left downwind for our runway. Actually. Well, we don't have to go all the way around this. We'll kind of cut between route 11 here. Yeah, right between the hills. Got a runway in sight. Level off the airplane right here. Just maintaining that speed. Look at 160 miles per hour there, so it's pretty fast. Pretty quick. You want to get from point A to point B. This is the way to do it. You can get in and out of Grapeseed, in and out of Sandy Shores with no problem. And Los Santos is not going to be an issue for us at all. Start our descent now. Over the mountains. Left downwind. Looking good here. We're going to reduce our speed here in a second. We'll actually go... Bring the engines back to idle. I'm not clicking the left one. We have plenty of runway here, so we don't have to worry about clicking the left trigger on this one. We're just going to keep it right at idle all the way in. Continue that descent. Looking good here. Nice clear day. That's runway 12 left, 12 right there. Pretty much wings are even with the threshold there. Go gear down. Let the airplane slow up even more. Continue out this way a little bit more. Remember, we have our little lines to look at on the mini-map we can use. That second one is a pretty good one to keep right about. So keep that descent going as we start our left turn. We'll get a nice... get a nice left base for the runway here. There it is right there. Right at the second line where we want to be. Make sure those land lights are on, and they are. Bring that nose up. There we go, and we can turn final now. Remember, just maintaining speed with the idle power, not clicking it left. Clicking the left trigger or anything. No need for that. Letting the airplane settle on its way down. A little right of the runway here, but we're okay. Seems to be good. A little correction to the right, and we'll be just fine. Have a lot of taxiway there, a lot of displaced threshold.
Attention aircraft.
Yeah, we know. Shoot us down.
Prohibited. Reverse course now.
About over the piano keys, gonna kill the engines here. Let it come on down. Oh, and the air. The police are here. We're down, just like that. Let's tell them to piss off. How about that? How about you piss off? Almost forgot. There, harden the brakes right there. We make our right turn here. And we'll overnight the airplane at the GA ramp. And then we'll, let's park back here somewhere. Doesn't really matter. But we'll do an evening flight into Sandy Shores. It is nighttime and it's raining, so lucky us. Let's go ahead and turn on our taxi light here. We're gonna taxi down to runway 30 right for our departure. It's a right turn on out of here, not a big deal. And I'll show you what I'm talking about with those emissives inside the cockpit. You get these bright things here, but it's not too bad. It's definitely doable for landing tonight, so that's good. Can actually see what I'm doing. We'll take off on 30 right. Be a quick departure here. We'll make a right-hand turn over the city, and we will head up Sandy Shores, and we'll land on the opposite runway. Actually, you know what? Let's just do the Zancudo River arrival. Do the river visual approach. We'll have to do the ILS, though, because there's no other. The visibility's probably going to be down, but I'm not really sure. Let's go full power. Our landing lights are on. Yes, they are. And airspeed is good. Pull it on back. Positive rate, gear up. Yeah, visibility's down a little bit, but not terrible. Not too bad. One thing I am noticing is that when you turn on the landing lights, actually, there's the taxi and the landing lights. They light up the whole interior here, so that's something that's kind of overlooked. Ooh, we're all right there. Okay, lightning is starting to pop up all over the place, and we are going to be on a long final for the left runway. Using our minimap for navigation on the way in. We'll turn to the right, stay far away from Zancudo. We've got 68, kind of follow 68 and the river. So gear's going to come down. I'm going to attempt to land this on the outside view, actually, because it's just too much on the inside when you have lightning happening. So landing light turns on the cabin lights as well. Those are good to go. Hit down on that D-pad so we can see a little bit further out there where that runway is, which we can see it pretty well. Let's look for those purple lights. A little bit more to the right. I've got the airfield in sight. We're looking okay on approach. Not going to be clicking that left stick or anything like that. No need for that. Plenty of airspeed, plenty of time to get it down. Wow, that is an incredible looking storm. That looks amazing. A little off course, a little more left. We're okay though, as far as altitude goes. Ooh, man. Turbulence and wind. And we're going to kill those engines as we come down into our round out to flare. Start flaring it back. We're down. Man, look at that lightning. That was awesome. That was a cool approach. I really did enjoy that. Yeah, the lights are pretty intense. We go back down to our taxi light and we're good. Pretty darn cool. Up a little bit here, and I'll go taxi over here and we'll shut her down. Still wish it turned a little tighter than it does, but it does all right. To the right, the left one is the one that's always slow, but that's a GTA thing for the most part. There we go. That's pretty good right there. I'm happy with it. Look at that. Lightning, that is such a cool look. We'll go vehicle options, engine off, and we'll shut her down. All right, well, that's gonna do it for this mod showcase of the Honda Jet. Let me know what you thought in the comments below. I really think this is gonna be a popular one you're gonna see in 5M, but that'll do it. I'll see you next time. Take care.